Hi everybody, welcome back. Today we're looking at two very simple words in English, the words with and by, and we're going to explore how to translate the various different meanings of these words into Greek. We're in Jeremy Duff, Elements of New Testament Greek, section 4.3 on pages 49 and 50. Now it's worth pausing on these two words, as Duff does, because they sometimes cause a bit of confusion. The reason for the confusion needs to be understood before we start. So let me just explain where the confusion arises. The reason why this sometimes is a bit tricky for people to understand is that both of the English words with and by can be used in English in more than one sense. But those different senses of both words get translated differently in Greek. So for example, the three instances that Duff has got here, the instrument, the agent, and the phrase which you might write in English, along with. Well, the word with in English can be used here and here. While the word by in English can be used here and here. So you see the confusion. People use the word by in English, and then they automatically plump for one or the other of these without thinking which one it actually should be. Or they use the word with in English, and they automatically plump for one or the other of these without thinking which of the two it should be. So in order to translate the words with and by accurately into Greek, what we need to do is to think not just about the word that we're using, is it with or is it by, but the meaning of that word in that context. And to do so, what we need to understand is the ideas or the concept of an instrument, an agent, and the phrase that Duff translates along with. Once we understand these concepts here in the green, it's a trivial matter just to remember how to translate them into Greek. So the what you do when you go from English into Greek is you think, what is the concept being represented here using the words with or by? And then you translate that concept accurately using the appropriate Greek phrase. Let me go through then the meaning of these three concepts and how you translate those into Greek. Here goes. First, let's talk about the instrument. The instrument, as Duff explains, is an inanimate thing by means of which an action is performed. So the one I like to use is, I was hit by a rock, or I was hit with a rock. In those two sentences, the phrase by a rock or with a rock describes an inanimate object, a thing, that is not performing the action, but is the means of which the action is performed, the means by which the action is performed. I was hit is the action, and by a rock or with a rock, it's an inanimate thing. We call it an instrument by means of which the action is performed. It might help you to think of this as like a tool. I hit my thumb with a hammer, or my thumb was hit by a hammer. In both those cases, it's like an inanimate thing that you crunch your thumb with and it's painful. Now, the way you translate that into Greek is simply by putting the rock or the hammer in the dative case. That's all you do. You just put the thing which is the instrument in the dative case. If it has the article goes in the dative case as well. Not complicated. Sometimes the preposition en is used, and you're used to thinking of en as meaning in, but as you know, prepositions, like all words, have a wide semantic range, and this is one potential part of the semantic range, that is the range of possible meanings of the word en. It can be used to express the instrument, but that's not as common as just sticking the thing that's the instrument in the dative case. Now, sometimes you'll hear people calling this the instrumental dative. I've written that phrase up there. Which is a fair enough thing to do, but it's important to understand what this means. The instrumental dative is not a special kind of dative. It is not a dative which is different in form from any other kind of dative. In your class, if you've been doing a Greek class, I bet when you got to this stage, if you've not got to it yet, then just watch out. Somebody's going to stick their hand up on the back row and say, please, sir, how do we know the difference between an instrumental dative and a normal kind of dative? Well, there's no difference grammatically, no difference at all grammatically or in the form of how the dative is used in this case. Really, when we say instrumental dative, we should be thinking it's the instrumental use of the dative. It's the instrumental use of the dative. We're using the dative to express the idea of the instrument, which is the inanimate object by which an action takes place. I was hit by, or I was hit with, a falling rock or a stick or something. That's the instrument. Second, an agent. Agent, I think, is easier to understand. The agent is a living being by which the action is performed. This occurs in the later chapter of the book when we start to explore the passive voice, which is the kind of form of a verb you get when instead of saying Paul wrote the letter, you say the letter was written. The letter was written. And then when you want to say who it was who did the writing of the letter, you say by Paul. Hupo plus Paul in the genitive. Now, what that really means for practical purposes, if you're working through Duff, is that you don't really need to worry about this at the moment. And I was even going to rub this out, but I thought probably annoy somebody because they want to see it on the whiteboard. But I don't want you to worry about this yet, for the simple reason that we're going to come to it when we actually start using it when we get to the passive voice much later in the book. But if you want to do the exercises, which is a good idea in Duff's book, then the agent is the personal entity or the living being who actually performs the action. So I was hit not by a falling rock, that would be the instrument. I was hit by my brother. Andrew, got my eye on you. I was hit by my brother, by Hupo. My brother is the agent by whom the action is performed. So you notice the difference. This is the inanimate thing which is utilized in order to perform the action. This is the actual living being that does the action. In English, we can use by or with to express the instrument. In English, we normally only use by to express the agent. Thirdly, the phrase which Duff translates along with, put along in brackets because you don't always use that in English, but let's suppose my brother had hit me, poor old me and big old him, but anyway, he'd hit me and then we'd made up afterwards and I decide, well, we're going to go to the pub together, so I'll make up and have a beer, and I say, I'm going to go to the pub with my brother. Well, the with there signifies a different sense of the English word with from what we meant up here. It's not like the meaning of the word, I was hit with a falling rock. It was hit, it has the sense of going along with, next to, beside, in the company of, perhaps better. So that sense of with, that you might translate along with, we don't use the dative or n plus the dative to translate that in Greek. No, we use meta plus the genitive, or more rarely, sun. Sorry, meta plus the genitive, or more rarely, sun plus the dative. Did I say meta plus the genitive first time? Goodness, I'm not sure. All right, meta plus the genitive. So after breakfast, I met a man with a big hat, right? So meta plus genitive means with, or sun plus the dative. That can mean, well, that means with. It's just a bit less common. So that's how to untangle these two English words, with and by, which create this confusion because both of them can be used in two different ways in English, which are represented in two different grammatical forms in Greek. Once you understand the meaning of what's being conveyed in English, then you can translate it into Greek. And of course, going from Greek into English is much easier because you understand the language that you're translating into. So once you understand the meaning in Greek, you can translate it appropriately into English. Okay, good work. Keep going with these exercises, keep going with these videos, keep going, working your way through Duff. We're going to be cracking on with section 4.4 in the next video. We'll be working through the rest of this chapter, so give it 20 minutes a day, give it 30 minutes a day for 5 or 6 days a week, and I can promise you we'll have you reading the New Testament in Greek in no time at all. Okay, God bless. Keep working hard. Bye for now.